be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, today the Holy Spirit gathered us together in this church to entrust to the Lord Brother Conda. We thank our generous and loving God for the gift of life and love He gave to Brother Conda. And so it is fitting to offer this Mass at Christian burial. In offering this Mass, we are offering the greatest of all prayers, the Eucharist. We are united with the prayer of Christ in His offering of Himself to the Father for us. More than that, we are proclaiming who it is that even in the face of death and the sadness of parting, we have hope. We believe that God will swallow up death forever. He has already begun to do so in the resurrection of Jesus, who being raised from the dead will never die again. Death no longer has any dominion over him. We know that he is beyond death and that he has invited us to follow him to death into new life. Brother Conrad was born to earth in life and then had been baptized. In the waters of baptism, he died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with Jesus Christ eternal glory. Sa kanyang pagsunod kay Kristo, dalawang bagay ang dati niyang hawa, Biblia at ang krus. May this book of the Gospel remind us of the beauty of the words that Brother Conrad shared with us, the joy of the Gospel. And he indeed shared in the Paschal mysteries of our Lord Jesus Christ. Life, death, and now resurrection. May he now rest in peace.
Amen. Please join in singing our hymn, which can be found in the green hymnal at number 556, I Know That My Redeemer Lives.
I love to see. Let us pray. God of our ancestors in faith, by the covenant made on Mount Sinai, you taught your people to strengthen the bands of family through faith, honor, and love. Look kindly upon brother, comrade, a husband, a father, a grandfather, who sought to bind his family to you. Sister Bing, comrade, Joseph, Marx, Brian, and Cindy. Bringing one day to our heavenly home, where the saints dwell in blessedness and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Christmas Carol song. Let the response be, the precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The law of the Lord is perfect, it revives the soul. The decrees of the Lord are steadfast, they give wisdom to the simple. Response,
the precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The fear of the Lord is pure, abiding forever. The judgments of the Lord are true, they are, all of them, just. Response,
the precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
So in them your servant finds instruction. Great reward is in their keeping. But who can detect their own errors? From hidden faults, acquit me. Response,
the precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
From presumptions, restrain your servant. May it not rule me. Then shall I be blameless, clean from grave sin. Response,
the precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
Reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, yet died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proved his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more once reconciled, we will be saved by his life. Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have not received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Then the righteous will answer him and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you? And the king will say to them in reply, Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me. Then he will say to those on his left, Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me. Then they will answer and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or ill, or in prison, and not minister to your needs? You will answer them, Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me. And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And to Mary, our mother, who always intercedes and is closer to our brother Jesus, we pray. Hail Mary.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death.
Amen. Whenever we have charismatic, this is the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
And even at the funeral, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Even in the sadness of our heart, we need to rejoice with our loving God. How blessed are the comrades today that we have many priests with us. Father Ness, Father Alex, Father Noel, and then we have also future priests, our deacon Ryan. And so, this is what you've been praying, that there will always be priests who will serve our community. But today, as we gather together, something that we always need to reflect. Last Saturday, what a wonderful celebration. Although we were sad that physically Brother Conrad and family were not here, but spiritually they are present. And so we continue the celebration. And in celebrating that great event, pinadalahanan po ang bawat isa. Sa Pilipinas, may mga simulteryo na pagkakayong pumasok, nakalagay ay kami ngayon, ikaw bukas. We are today, you will be tomorrow. And something to reflect, that yes, we will be tomorrow, but what does that mean? We always need to be prepared. We always need to be ready. And so even at the funeral self-mass, we're all being reminded of the gift and responsibility that we received when we were all baptized. At the very beginning, we bless the body of Brother Conrad in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and we put this white cloth to remind us of the white cloth that he received when he was baptized. Sign of a Christian dignity that his parents and my parents will challenge not to put any stain on this cloth. But of course, we know that we all fail. But we all committed sin. And that's why we have the sacrament of confessions. And then we have the symbols, the book of the gospel, and then the cross. The cross that reminds us of the great symbol of our salvation. When we are all baptized, when we pour, when we bless with the holy water. And then after pouring the holy water, then there is the anointing, the prison form that we share in the priestly, prophetic, and kingly function of Jesus Christ.
And because of that, we've been given a gift, a wonderful gift, to share in the priesthood, in the prophetic, and the kingly function of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so it is a gift and a responsibility. But, of course, we used to go on our own way. And we tend to unlock everything. And so, it's all right. People have been doing that, I can do that too. But then we realize that there is always a God who is a loving and forgiving God. In the back is, the Lord's mercies have never failed me. What return shall I make to him? 2 weeks ago, Jesus asked his disciples, who do you say, who do people say that I am? Elijah, they were prophets. But at the end, he asked them, but you, who do you say that I am? It's a personal question that you only yourself could respond. In the light of our Father on water, he accepted the baptism with great gift and responsibility. Of course, he did also a good life, a bad life, but with Sister Lee, they're able to really see the beauty of marriage, the beauty of God's love that they need to always preserve in their married life. And how much more, it's not only to your 46 years of happy and fruitful marriage, but you're able to learn also to share it with many people, not only the adults, but even the young ones. And that is wonderful. If I will ask you, who do you say that Brother Conrad is to you? Each and every one of us could say something about Brother Conrad. As a husband, as a father, as a grandfather, as a brother, as a friend, an uncle, and many other things. And those descriptions of what we will remember about Brother Conrad will be his path to enter the kingdom of heaven. Because if we will think of Brother Conrad today, what will come up to our mind is all the good works that he had done to us and in this world. And those good works that he shared with us are all manifestations of God's presence in his life that he shared to all of us. You know, I like what happened after the first reading. We do not know what to do. Joseph, your dad will be very happy that you just initiated and that you did it. We pray that you will find the footsteps of your dad and the rest of your family, of course. Today we are having the 8th World Meeting of Families in Philadelphia. Love is our mission, family fully alive. And so we need to go to basic. We need to love and respect each other, especially members of our own family. No matter what happened, let's entrust that past to the divine mercy of our loving God. How many times that Brother Conrad prayed and sung the Divine Mercy Chaplet. He prayed for himself, he prayed for all of us, that God's mercy be upon us. But how much more to you, his family, that he wants love, respect, and forgiveness. And so he trusts your past to the divine mercy. And now as you live in this present, in this today, live in the divine love. And then your future in the divine providence. In our gospel today, we're being reminded of the feast of the Christ the King, when we will be judged of what we did in this world. How you love and serve your brothers and sisters. The precepts of the Lord, I don't know whether it's just an instant that you open the book and you found it, but the precepts of the Lord is joy in our hearts. And indeed, if we heed in the precepts of the Lord, and what is the greatest commandment? You can make it now. Love God above all things with your whole heart, mind, soul, and strength, and then to love your neighbor as you love yourself. Always remember, God asks us first to love God. Because in loving God, we will have the power and the strength to love our brothers and sisters, especially those who are so difficult to love, and sometimes its members of our own family. God has given us a wonderful body. We use our eyes, our ears, so that we can see the world and the needs of our brothers and sisters. And so we have here to see and to hear. But there is also the heart, so that we will be able to judge and to choose the right thing. And then we have the hands to act and to embrace each other. Whenever we extend our hands, what symbol do we form in our life? It's a cross. And this is a symbol of our salvation. Love God above all things with your whole heart, mind, soul, and strength, and then to love your neighbor as you love yourself. See, judge, and act. But there is another fourth element, and that is celebration. To celebrate whatever God has done for us. And today, in a special way, we celebrate a beautiful night of Brother Conrad. Let us think of the love and all the guidance, all the advices that He shared with us. Were we blessed in Philadelphia that it was his last time to have the seminar, the Life in the Spirit seminar. And then after that, he learned that he has cancer. But he accepted it. He prayed and prayed. And his prayer been answered last Saturday. Now he's resting in peace. But know that our relationship with Brother Conrad is not the end, but it's the fullness of his life and the continuation of our relationship. We have a great intercessor in heaven. As we pray for him today, be assured that he will be praying for all of us. Brother Conrad, we thank you for everything that you have done for us. And may all the things that you have shared and implanted to us may be able to continue that. Last Saturday, I also mentioned the highest form of loyalty that you can give to Brother Conrad is what?
Imitation.
Each of us must imitate all the good qualities that he has shared with us. And can you imagine that we will all be preaching the good news of Jesus Christ? This world will be fullness of life. Please stand.
He may be raised now.
up on the last day, we pray to you.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters, especially Brother Conrad. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Being here, O Lord, we pray. To your servant, Brother Conrad, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any state of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has known, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled with the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven.
And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
May be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously made holy, these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
When we discern between this
celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and his ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all your saints, on his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing power.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Arthur our Bishop, the order of bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your love. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Conrad. Pray that he was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. But from the earth, we will raise up in the flesh those who love God. Transform our lowly body after the pattern of your own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you as they're passing from this life, give an admittance to your kingdom. That we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise without end.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Oh,
may grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Oh, I love you. Thank you.
We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, for the wonderful gift that you have given us, our beloved brother of God. Come, follow your will, and put your servant among us. We commend him to you, that you may now fully rest in your presence. Brother Conrad, please pray for each one of us, that like you, was able to follow Christ, we may be able to do so. Help us that we may carry the threefold functions of Jesus as a priest, as a prophet, and as a king, and that we may accept it as a gift and as a mission. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Conrad in the sure and certain hope that together with all that died in Christ, he will rise with me on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Father Conrad in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowships with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant good brother, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Conrad forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Done. Huh? Battery's done. Almost done.
That's it. Patayin mo na.